Yes, dear students, already we have discussed about family lesson, the first chapter in sociology. I will give you notes about the family lesson. Take it. Yes, dear friends, fill in the blanks with suitable words in the family lesson. The first one is, the word family is derived from the Latin word. Already you know that. What the term? The famulus. The Latin word, the family word come from famulus. One. Second one, the cell of the society is, the smallest unit of the society or cell of the society is what? That is family. Next, if the father is the head of the family, the family is called as, in which family father is the head of the family? Say, nothing but the patriarchal family. Here, father is the head of the family, that is known as patriarchal. Next, mother is the head of the family, matriarchal. Okay. See, among the Nayars in Kerala, their family is found nowadays. Nowadays, we have found in the Nayar family in Kerala, that is the matriarchal family, highly existed. Okay. Next, answer the following questions. How does the family become a social unit? How do you call family is a social unit? See, the answer is, family is a unit of society and every activities of social institutions start from the family. You know, without the family, there is no activities of any not start. So family is very very important to start any social activities in the society. What are the fields? The political, economic, educational and several other activities of the society begin from the family. Okay. Then the members of the family are the members of the social institutions also. Members of the family, they are within the social institution. Already I have told you that school, religion, mass media, family, marriage. So these are all social institution. The family is in the social institution. That means it is worked under the social institution. So the community develops from a family. Here the different community are existed in society. So these are developed from a family. Everyone developed in a family and leading to the creation of nation, leading to the creation of generation and also nation. So that's why the family became a social unit. The generation is helpful to make unit there. See, the next question, mention the types of family. The family is classification on the basis of nature. What are the nature? Say, one is family based on kinship. So family based on residence of the spouse. The spouse residence is matriarchal or patriarchal. On the basis of that, the family can be matriarchal family and a patriarchal family classified. Next, on the basis of nature of authority, family is classified as matriarchal and patriarchal family. On the basis of ancestry or descent, family is also classified as matriarchal and patriarchal family also, ancestry. And based on the structure and the generations live together. Here, generation live both together. Families are divided as nuclear family, joint family and extended family. Already we have discussed. Next, what is joint family? The family that has more and more generations living together is called joint family. See, it normally consists of grandfather, grandmother, their children, and also their grandchildren and grandchildren and some situation. So the member belong to extended one more here, that is called joint family. And what is a nuclear family? See, already I have given definition about nuclear family. Here, father and mother and their unmarried children. Father, mother and their unmarried children is known as nuclear family. So, what are the characteristics of family? See, family is universal. That means family is universal. We have found wherever you go without the family. That means it is judged all corner of the society. So that is called family. Various in accordance to specific geographical nature and time period, and the family is found in all societies. Usually the family is following a fixed pattern in issues like marriage, nurturing, kinship and property rights. Everything also they have. So that is, family is universal. Wherever you go, you have found. The second one, it is the basic unit for all social activities. So family is based to do any social activities like political, economical, educational and several other activities of the society. So these are all begin from the family. So it is the basic unit for all social activities. Next one, continuous responsibility and also social accountability. Here responsibility also continue, there is no stop, and accountability also very essential. So the family teaches its member how to behave and how to discharge the specific responsibilities. The family has given so many responsibility to so many different members. So they have to do their responsibility in the family. That's why it trains its children on how to live harmoniously with the neighbors. How he should live with harmonious with the neighbors, with friendly natures. Next, bringing up and nurturing. Nowadays, the people create their basic rights and responsibilities with regard to children, and it also protects them. So, family members protect elder to younger one, younger also protect the elder ones in their family. So, bringing up and nurturing children or elder, anybody is in the family. Next one, teaches social behavior. Nowadays, everyone learns something good behavior from their family. So, the childhood and adolescence are very important stages in the process of socialization. The childhood nature is different from elder nature. So, a child learns here mother tongue from the family and also understand social life around what happened to the child. It through the master mother tongue. Any language learn a child by the family, mother tongue, master. And children develop as per the social situation around the family. How the social situation around the family, on the basis of that, the children can grow. Last one, it inserts the traditions. So each and every traditions, each and every family had their traditions, beliefs, customs, rituals, everything also. The family member also get guidance. It inserts the tradition. Family includes several generations. It introduces the kinship and it outlines the relationship between grandfather and grandmother and father, mother and siblings. Sibling means brotherhoodness. It teaches that grandparents make the first generation, first one, and the parents from the second generation, second, and the children form the third generation. Okay, children third generation, parents second generation, grandfather and mother first generation. So on the basis of this generation, everyone is interacted by younger one to the elder one, elder one to the younger tradition. Everything followed by the tradition. Discuss the role of family in individual social development stages. Say the childhood, adolescence are very important stages in the process of socialization. A child loses its mother tongue in the family already now. It understands the social life around it through the mastered mother tongue. How? Because the mastering over the our language by the family, is it? So children also learn or mastered over their language by the family. So develop as per the social situation and the family. Their development and social position also, social situation also developed. The family teaches the children about the ways of interacting with others and the peer group. The family teaches to their family members how to interact with others, how to interact with peer group, friends, and others and younger ones. Everyone taught by the family. This means the social behavior and the social demands and the social taboos. Taboos means abolish. Any abolish by the family and indirectly control the children. These are all very essential to control, to take the control of the family members, elder one to the younger one. The family teaches behaviors like friendship, behavior, freedom and security during childhood and adolescence and adulthood and old age. All stages cared by the family here. So next one, explain the characteristics of a joint family. Already you got the large in size, number of people are there, more joint family, it consists people, two more generation, and so it is large in size. Second one, coordination, cooperation always exist are found in the joint family day by day. All the activities of the day to day life. And next, the third one, residence and kitchen in nuclear joint family, same, there is no change at all. Next, religion, members of the joint family have beliefs and patterns, traditions, religions, everyone also only one. Their worship and religious belief are common in nature, not different. Last one, the self sufficient. The joint family member, they have their own self-sufficient, self-satisfaction and showed their love and affection each and everyone in their family. It satisfies all the needs of the family members. All the needs of the family members. Next, structure of authority. Joint family, the structure of authority, head of the institution, and authority and responsibility handling by elders or senior. The handing over of authority is based on the seniority in the family. The senior is very, very important in the joint family. Next, what are the reasons for the increase of nuclear family in the present day? May ask question in your examination. Nowadays, we have seen the nuclear family more present in the urban area compared to me. What are the reason? I will give you answer. Family that consists of father and mother and their unmarried children and members is called a nuclear family. Father, mother and their unmarried children. One thing. The nuclear families have increased in modern society, you know, because of individuality focus. They want freedom from the elders. The individuality is one causes, then focus on individual achievement, not a family achievement, second point. And third one, concept of individual happiness, their happiness, individuality, they concentrate their happiness only, not the joint family or member's happiness. And change in value system, they are not ready to follow the traditions of the joint family, so that is also a reason. And regard to rights of the property. So, value system not ready to follow, and rights system property they want, but not ready to take any responsibility and progress in the areas of science and technology. They have concentrated the progress of science and technology and advanced technology, they are attracted. And rapid urbanization, that is also a main point for the nuclear family organizing or setting nowadays. And democratic values, democratic values they have concentrated, that's why they want to live separate from joint family. And concept of equality, they are not ready to tolerate and suffering from anyone. They want equal, either elder or younger one, both are equal, they want. And many other things have contributed to the rise of nuclear families. Not only this, there are some other factors also helpful to make the nuclear family. So these are all the points for the development of nuclear family in the word also. Okay, the chapter notes also over.